Hello all, welcome to Study Table. Our today's topic is sources of recruitment. Well, job is a term to which almost we all can relate. Students do studies to get a good job. Many institutions are running to making aspirants ready to approach for the job. Placement sales are growing business nowadays, which helps people in finding jobs. Even girls' father first ask for the job. Well, these all aspect making this term more important in one's life. Similarly, job is as much as important to the companies as well. They always be in a search of good talents and suitable candidates. And this search operation is called recruitment. Means, recruitment is a process of searching candidates and attract them to apply for the job. Basically, recruitment facilitates selection process. Means, first by recruitment, they can be attracted to apply for the job and accordingly get selected. Okay? Now we'll move towards recruitment sources. Means from where we can get the aspirants or suitable candidates. Okay? So here we have two sources of recruitment. One is internal sources and second one is external sources. Internal sources refers to sources from within the company only. Means no need to go outside in a search of candidates. Vacant positions will be filled internally over here. Alright? By firstly, promotions. That is, if suppose vacancy arises at a higher level, then qualified, experienced and deserving employee from within the company only can be promoted at the higher level, right? Then we have internal ads. The company may display job vacancies on its official website, notice boards, sending mails to existing employees or making announcements for the same. So accordingly, interested candidates may apply for the position, right? Sometimes retired employees may be recalled, especially for a short duration. This method is usually used at times when it is difficult to find the suitable and trustworthy candidates for the higher position especially. The vacancy can also be filled through internal transfers, means an existing employee who is experienced and capable enough for handling the duties in the new department or in other branches can be transferred. So this all is internal sources of recruitment. Sometimes internal sources are favorable, but at times not. Let's have a look first on some merits or advantages of internal sources. Very firstly, it is very economical as there is no need to spend huge amount of money on advertisement in external media. Even only making just oral announcement will be enough. Then it is time saving as well. There is no need to conduct interviews of several candidates. It improves morale and develops loyalty of the employees towards the organizations as they feel important and valuable asset of the company. Internal recruitments automatically or naturally triggers them to become satisfied and motivated employees. And yes, again, there is no need to conduct orientation or induction training as internal candidates are already familiar with the rules and regulations and the policies of the organizations, right? Secondly, we have some disadvantages or demerits of internal sources too. Firstly, there may be a possibility of biasness or partiality in promoting or transferring employees from within the company. Also prevents outside talents with innovative ideas, fresh thinking and dynamism from entering the company, right? That means no outsider allowed here at all. And therefore, it provides limited scope. limited ground for selection and there may be possibility of not finding the suitable candidates, right? Because we have a limited choice here. It may generate discontent or demotivation among those who are not promoted, right? They may get upset and that's natural, yeah? And by doing all these, we are losing competitive advantages. Company will definitely face the music in long run. So this all is some positive and negative sides of internal sources of recruitment. Now let's understand some of the external sources. External sources means candidates from outside the company, okay? Which includes, firstly, advertisements. We can invite candidates from outside through displaying job vacancy in various external media like newspapers, business magazines, job-related websites such as Naukri.com, MonsterIndia.com and such websites like that. Then we have recommendations. Means the company may also recruit or hire employee through the recommendation of the existing employees or from any other recommendation group. Alright? Then yes, campus recruitment. Sometimes company may visit campus of educational institutions and recruit the suitable candidates from there. Firms may also can take help of consultants to select the candidates for their organizations. The consultant may be some experts from their respective fields, can be retired and experienced employee of the company, okay? As we discussed earlier, placement agencies are growing business nowadays who supply suitable manpower to the needy company according to their requirements. So that's how employees can be recruited from outside the company by all these external sources. Now let's have a look on some merits and demerits of the same. Firstly, we'll start with advantages. There is a less possibility of biasness or partiality as outside candidates has less scope in influencing selection decisions, right? Also, it offers wider scope in selection as large number of candidates may appear for the same job. It also encourages outside fresh talents, people with innovative ideas to join the organization. And all these collectively give competitive advantage to the company for the survival in this most competitive era ever. Okay. Now move towards some of the disadvantages of external sources. It may be possible that it affects the loyalty of existing employees as rather to give first priority or chance to them, company welcoming outsider. So definitely it will hurt, right? Then yes, it is time and efforts consuming as well. Because induction training or orientation is must to give as they are very new to the company and to its environment. And of course, it will take a long hour to conduct tests and interviews of a large number of candidates. External sources are expensive as it requires a huge amount of money on advertisement in external media. Then only outside people will get to know about the vacancy and will get attracted and will apply for the same. So same as internal sources, we have both advantages and disadvantages of external sources as well. So basically, sources of recruitment means the areas from which suitable and potential employees can be attracted to apply for the job. All right. And accordingly get selected, right? Hope you all understand the topic well. We'll meet soon with a new topic, new concept. Till then, Study Table wishes you all the very best.